And welcome to the Board of Commissioners meeting, July 26, 2022, 4 p.m. I'm going to read into the record the open meeting law. Pursuant to the open meeting law, any person may make an audio or video recording of this public meeting or may transmit the meeting through any medium. Attendees are therefore advised that such recordings or transmissions are being made, whether perceived or unperceived, by those present and are deemed acknowledged and permissible. Sue, can you call the roll?
Detective Brown.
Present.
Commissioner Caffley.
Present.
Director Duca.
Present.
Chief Jackson.
Present.
Chair Crisco.
Present. We do have a full board today, and I will get right to agenda item number one. Hearing regarding the request of the City of Quincy for a special use permit, one-day liquor license for the Multicultural Folk Festival kickoff featuring Ronan Tynan at 6 p.m. on Saturday, August 6th at the Hancock Adams Common. John McDonald is supporting the kickoff to the folk festival. However, he's unable to be here today. The permit for Sunday was previously approved by adding Saturday for Ronan Tynan for the kickoff. Also, with that request, I did get a request, and my fault for not putting it on the agenda was a request to extend the hours at the Beer Garden at Kilroy Square on August 6th after the Ronan Tynan concert till 11 p.m. I apologize for that, but Tim Cahill is here from the Quincy Chamber of Commerce. If you have any comments, would love to have you come up and talk about the event that evening. Thank you.
I won't speak for John McDonald, but I know it's going to be a big event here at the Common, which goes from 6 to 8. Usually the beer garden closes at 9, or the hours are 9, but there's going to be an after party at Kilroy Square, meet and greet for Ronan Tynan, for people to meet him and get to talk to him and sign autographs and things like that from 8 to 10. So we'd like to extend the beer garden hours to close at 11 instead of at 9 o'clock for that night, so we can include people and they can come all the way through the square, down from here, down through the square, the beer garden, or any of the restaurants down there as well. They already have their extensions until 1 a.m. anyway, so that's all we're looking for, is to extend that.
I appreciate your
okay.
update. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Are there any questions, concerns from anyone regarding, first, the request from the City of Quincy for the special use permit for the one-day liquor license for the Multicultural Folk Festival on Saturday, August 6th? Yes.
John Rutherford, 62 Grandwall Road. I was researching, and the Patriot Ledger actually wrote an article promoting this already. You know what I'm saying? So it kind of makes like these board meetings look like it's not even like a real thing. Like it's already approved. You know, like they really should wait. You know, like if, you know, Mary Whitfield, if you're watching from the Patriot Ledger, you should wait until something gets approved before it's advertised. Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate that. Any other questions, concerns? Seeing none. Also, I would like to extend, if anyone would like to come up and speak about the extension of the hours at the Beer Garden at Kilroy Square on August 6th till 11 p.m. Any questions, concerns? Seeing none, looking for two votes.
I'd like to make a motion to grant the request of the City of Quincy for a special use permit, one-day liquor license for the Multicultural Folk Festival kickoff featuring Ronan Tynan at 6 p.m. on Saturday, August 6th on the Hancock Adams Common.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
I'd like to make a motion to extend the closing hours till 11 p.m.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. You're all set. Thank you. Second on the agenda is hearing regarding the request of Prestige Car Wash for a gasoline repair license for the premise located at 635 Washington Street. Due to a change of ownership, currently All in One Automotive. Proposed manager Ken Calabro. Proposed hours of operation 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Ken Calabro, are you here? Oh, Caitlin, why don't you come up? Thank you. And if you don't mind telling us what's going to happen there at 635 Washington Street.
So everything's going to be staying exactly the same. It's just change of ownership. Prestige Capital Group is purchasing the property.
Okay.
Keeping everything.
And your name again for the record?
Caitlin Healy.
Caitlin Healy. And your address?
500 Turnpike Street, Canton.
Thank you. And do you work there? Are you an employee or just on?
I do the licensing for the company.
Okay, thank you. So Ken Calabro was unable to be here today.
He's the manager. I told them it was either going to be one or the other.
Okay, all right.
He was stuck in office.
Okay, thank you. Anyone have any questions, concerns regarding Prestige Car Wash for a gasoline repair license for the premise located at 635 Washington Street due to a change of ownership? Seeing none. Board members, any questions, concerns? Looking for a motion.
I'd like to make a motion to grant the request of Prestige Car Wash for a gasoline repair license for the premises located at 635 Washington Street due to change in ownership. Currently All in One Automotive. Proposed manager is Ken Calabro. Proposed hours of operations are 7 a.m. to 8 p.m. represented by Caitlin Healy.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Agenda item number 3, continued from June 21st. Hearing regarding the request of Off the Hook Bar and Grill, LLC, doing business as Off the Hook Bar and Grill, John Galligan, manager, for an alteration of license premise at 1269 C Street to reflect outdoor dining and patio area of 1,625 square feet, which includes addition of new walk-up bar with 4 seats. The outdoor area accommodates seating for 44. That will be represented by attorney Robert Fleming. For the record, the board received the following items of correspondence on this item. Summary of proposed use of outdoor space from Mr. Galligan, which he and his attorney can review. Correspondence between Director Butters and Counselor McCarthy regarding Butters' concerns on the placement of the dumpster. Counselor McCarthy understands the Butters' concerns and is hopeful these issues can be resolved in such manner to move forward with everyone's concerns addressed. We got 23 letters in support, including one from Counselor at Large Noel DeBona, and a letter and pictures of opposition from owner at 1259 C Street. At this time, I'll ask Attorney Fleming and Mr. Galligan to present their request, and then we can get questions and feedback from others in the audience. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Members of the board, Rob Fleming again from Fleming and Fleming. Nice to see you today. Thank you for hearing this case. So again, this matter was continued from the June hearing due to the inability of one abutting property owner not being able to appear. So we did agree to continue this to today's date. So very important to note to the board is that the application before the board is twofold. One is merely a correction of the square footage of the patio space for the restaurant. The original plan that was filed for the original application, original license, is the same plan that we have today. Inadvertently, the square footage was much less than what's actually there today. So we're submitting this application.
Which
to,
is
to
what
correct
was advertised.
That. That's correct.
Right.
That's correct, yes. Secondfold, Mr. Galligan and his wife Brooke are adding a small bar in one of the patio areas. This is merely for logistics, for service of that particular patio area. We've spoken to neighbors. John was able to speak to the neighbor that was not able to appear in June. She had some concerns with the use of the patio, even though it's been used, since he's opened, for over a year now. She did have some concerns, I think, because of the installation of the proposed bar, service bar, in that particular patio area. So John did, was able to speak to her or communicate with her nevertheless. John and Brooke have been very responsive to NAEP. It's a pretty dense area, as you all know. They have responded to concerns with respect to these patio areas in the past, installing 8-foot fencing, which really shields these particular areas. It does dampen any noise and things of that nature from those areas as well. With respect to the dumpster area, you know, John is out there day in and day out, you know, cleaning that. It is picked up once a week by Republic. They are supposed to. Do they every time deodorize it? If they don't, John's staff do. They do deodorize it. So out there, quite frequently. John met with, I believe, Mr. Duca and Marley as well concerning fencing that particular area. So John is getting prices to fence the area. There's only so many places they're able to you know, move this dumpster. So they really have to keep it in this particular location. But they will fence it in as well. Just today, right before the hearing, John did speak to a neighbor, just got some complaints or just a request from the neighbor behind. They have a shared easement for access. They share it for both their own employee vehicles as well as the dumpster, you know, pickup as well, about being able to try to do some fencing, which is very difficult, you know, but John's going to look at that to see if there's anything he's able to do. To kind of shield their home or his restaurant from their home, but it's very difficult because it's a pretty narrow easement. It's shared. I think most of it appears to be on John's property of the restaurant, and they both share it for access purposes. But you know, Brooke and John have been very diligent, you know, about responding to neighborhood concerns. It's a very dense neighborhood. They've been very successful, you know, certainly with the help of this board as well. As you saw, there was a lot of neighborhood support as well for the restaurant. No complaints that we're aware of with the operations of the restaurant. So again, requesting just on this application, a correction of the square footage of the patio area, as well as just a small little service bar for one of the patio areas. With respect to hours of operation, kitchen closes at 9 o'clock. The entire restaurant does, you know. So patio areas, people are obviously allowed to finish food, drinks. They really can't order any more food after that specific time. At a certain time, you know, if people are gonna, you know, want to stay, John brings them in inside in the restaurant. So you probably won't see anybody out there beyond what time, John?
I mean, if someone's ordering food at, you know, a few minutes before 9, how would he eat? I mean, I would think by 10 o'clock completely, everyone is off those patios. Area's cleaned, doors are closed. It's usually when any live music we have on the inside, we're wrapping up, so we kind of force them in there to, they want to have another drink or anything like that.
And any music that's played in the patio areas, everybody likes a nice ambiance, you know, to be able to listen to some music when they're eating as well. That's turned down. If you ever fielded a complaint from a neighbor about if the music was ever loud, certainly John and Brooke would make sure that was turned down to a proper level, sound level as well. Any questions from the board?
Thank you.
Sure.
Appreciate it.
Okay.
I'd like at this time to ask any neighbors, any one here speaking either in favor or in opposition of off the hook, to please make your way orderly to the front here. Thank you.
Thank you. My name is Susan Boyd. I abut off the hook on the Bayview Ave side. My address is 117 Bayview Ave. I own that address with my brother, Stephen Boyd. We also share a driveway with off the hook. Our concerns are about the two egresses that seem to be built on the shed that they've added to the patio. Already, there are staff and customers exiting the restaurant and patio through the egresses. We don't really have a lot of privacy. We would like a privacy fence. it's our understanding that the property line, he talked about an easement. When my father originally owned Louis Crossing with Donald Satori years ago, and we separated the property. It was a commercial lot with the house and the restaurant, you probably remember. We separated it through DeSalle, did the land surveying. Callum and Callum did the real estate. There was an easement. Proposed easement shows on the plot plan. From what I understand, I spoke with Callum and Callum about a year ago when they were building, when Off the Hook was building the patio. The final language for the easement never went in. My understanding now is there is no formal language for the easement. So a fence, either party, from what I understand from my lawyers, either party can put a fence down the property line. So I'm open to either that, with the property line, like you said, goes down kind of like the middle of the driveway for the most part, or we're open to a fence on their side of the easement. They don't need parking. They sold their parking lot. They have, I'm asking the city to make the privacy fence a condition of their approving any more building of this structure. I don't know if they pulled a deed or a permit to build what they've built so far. I don't know what the details are on that. I've been a good neighbor. You haven't seen my face complaining about anything they've done up until this point. They've been fairly decent neighbors too. I understand they have problems with the dumpster. I would like to see a privacy fence engulfing all of their equipment, the dumpster, all their equipment, the smoking section, their staff is out there smoking, the egresses. Customers are going to want to exit through that. In their defense, they are saying they're going to keep it so that customers don't exit through the driveway, but that parking lot is right there, and people are going to see that it's the fastest way to exit. They are going to try and do that. It happened just the other day. If they put a nice little trellis up their side of the driveway, people, both they and myself, can still park, the deliveries can still come. Maybe they'll lose a little bit of space, but I want to see, and I'll finalize with this, I would like to see some type of trellis that we can make it nice, engulfing their equipment, the dumpster, the smoking section for the staff, the break section for the staff, and the egresses all the way down to the patio. So that it could be like a nice little alleyway. You've seen them in other restaurants. We have no privacy. We have people at the eye level that we are at now, smoking in the driveway, exiting, and when they were closed, teenagers were all over the place. I have no complaints other than, you know, I know the dumpster, we owned the restaurant before they did. I understand the problems they're up against. I'm not trying to stop them from being successful. They've only done everything that we wanted to do. But I want my privacy. And I'm really serious about this. And I think that possibly, I don't know why we're here in the middle of the summer talking about this. This should have been discussed in the winter. All the lawyers are away. I hate to bring in lawyers, but this easement issue is something that needs to be discussed before any more building is taken place, I think. Thank you. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Next.
Good afternoon. My name is Mike Perez. I live at 1260 C Street. I live right in front of the restaurant. I've been living there over 18 months now. It's a brand new home. And I just want to give support to the restaurant. They've been very respectful. I see John always out there cleaning up. He does have an area where people would go out of his restaurant and smoke in front, but he's always there cleaning up in the area. And he always is very cognizant about what, you know, how it looks. So I have no problem with the time and the hours. He's very respectful in those areas as well. So I just wanted to go on the record for that. Thank you.
I will just note for the record that all the correspondence that were written, all of the members of the board have them. And so for that, we probably won't get into reading them all out loud. You have an opportunity to come up and speak, which is here for you today. Your concerns are being heard in your letters and your emails, and we will take those all into consideration before the board renders a decision, okay? Again, if anybody would like to get up and speak. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam President. Members of the board, thank you for letting me speak. I'm in here to support this restaurant, and I'll tell you what John has done.
Can we just have you say your name and address for the record?
Martin Akins, 81 Mears Ave. Me and Mr. Duca went down there when he was thinking of opening this up, and we took a walk through the place. And anything that Mr. Duca has asked him, he's done. And he's talked to me through this whole thing, and I gave him some ideas. I think John's a hard worker, very hard worker. And I'd like to see this get passed. I appreciate it. Thanks.
Thank you. Please state your name and address for the record.
Hi, Margaret O'Neill Simone, and I'm the abutter to Off the Hook, 1259 C Street. I just come around the corner and see a bar built is just, you know, I mean, I've owned that property since 2000. I have no issue. This is not personal. They are wonderful people. I know all of their families, but I don't want a bar next door to my property. Like, we already have the dumpster. My tenants, you know what I mean? Everyone should have the ocean breeze to smell, but we don't. And there's rats, you know? And just hearing, you know, it's like being in someone's living room looking down there. They did put the fence up. We used to have 20-foot trees in between that we're taking out. The dumpster used to be on the other side where there was never an issue. It was on the patio, I mean the pavement, not near like the grass area or, you know, the bushes or any of that. You know, my tenants have to keep their windows closed. You know, I'm just not for it. Like, maybe if it was on the parking lot side or something, you know, I have no issue with John making money, believe me. I have supported him in every way. I've had cancer walks just because we're friends parties. He asked me to put his beer truck in my driveway, and I absolutely did not want to do that, but I was thinking of the community who was all excited for it. And, you know, and then I thought, like, the money and the business that he was going to lose, you know, him and his family, and I let him have it. I've been a good neighbor, you know. I mean, basically, you just ask people, come up and talk to people. You know what I mean? You just don't go and do things. I mean, that's, we're neckers. We always help each other out. And I don't feel like he's been fair in any of that way. You know, and I really just don't want all that noise, and that's what it's going to be. It's going to be all that noise. And, you know, four bar stools mean to me, four people sitting down and 20 people standing up, drinking, hooting and hollering or whatever. You know, that's how I feel.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Leanne McGarry. My address is 37 Meeting House Lane, Weymouth. I am Peggy's sister, Margaret's sister. So like she said, she is not at all against them making money and doing well, and it's great to see people do well. I think the dumpster is a huge concern with the rats and things that being right up against her property. And her tenants that are there now do not have the peaceful enjoyment of the property. It's Howes Neck. We're there for the summer. Like, that's why we're there. We're not there for the winter when the windows are closed and it's cold out. We'd like to, you know, people want to use their outside. and there's no quiet enjoyment of the outside when there's a bar right on your property line. The bar was there originally when she bought the property, but it was an inside bar. I'm not sure if there was even a permit pulled for this bar that was built. Do we know? Do we have that information?
I do not. I guess we could go to Director Duca.
There was no permit.
Okay, so how do we open a bar without a permit? I'm not really sure how that works. How we build a bar without a permit. I think that legally we're supposed to build a permit and get a license, everything legally. I'm not sure how the square footage was changed from 300 to 1600, or was there a mistake made? Like, how did that happen? We don't really know that. Would like to see them be open and happy and enjoying, you know, the summer. Not too late at night, the noises. The bar situation is just facing her property and the noise will come. I don't know if there's any other way to block that or to move the dumpster over, but those are her major concerns. Is there a setback, right, of where the patio can start, the seating area, and the dumpster?
I guess I would refer to health.
Yeah, we haven't even looked that far yet into it.
Okay. Thank you for your concerns.
All right, thank you.
I just want to, will my letter be in the records?
We have it, yes.
Okay.
We have it. Thank you.
Thank you.
And your pictures. Thank you. Anyone else wishing to speak?
John Rotafail, 62 Grenwell Road. Louise has been there forever, a long time. So, I mean, there've been, you know, that business was actually probably more busy than it is right now when it was hopping in its heydays. So I don't really understand, like, the change of, like, the use. It's always been, like, a busy place where people have been drinking and going for something to eat. So the majority of the people who live in Howes Neck are in favor of this, and I think that, you know, you shouldn't hold the applicant up anymore. I think that, you know, Mr. Galligan is a true Necker, and this is what the Neckers want. So I think that, you know, it's unfortunate if you live right next door to a project like this, but it's not like the restaurant came out of nowhere. The restaurant has always been there. The good thing is that it's usually only, you know, people are only really busy on a Friday and a Saturday night. So there's not going to be people out there on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday night all the time bothering everybody. Basically, one of the things is, you know, the people smoking cigarettes. But right now, people smoke cigarettes outside of every bar room because you can't smoke cigarettes inside the bars anymore. I don't like seeing people smoking cigarettes outside of any bars, but that's just what happens. It's just how society works today. So I don't think we should waste any more time. I think you should just pass this and we should just end this. Thank you.
Thank you.
Can I say something else? This is the same gentleman that at the last meeting said going against John is like political suicide.
Excuse me.
You're out of order.
Completely. Anybody else wishing to speak in favor or opposition? Board members, questions, concerns?
Yeah, I'd like to say a few things, Nicole, if I may.
Yes, please.
So to address the issue of the permit, we have a stop work order on this particular, and he's not allowed to use it. And I held that in abeyance while we see how this played out at the license board. From hearing from the neighbors, I understand and I'm sympathetic to people in business. I want to see that, we all want to see them succeed. But to people should know that this is a business district. Single family homes are allowed as well as businesses. They have to coexist. From what I'm hearing from the neighbors, they've tolerated the restaurant being there because they know it's a restaurant and they've tolerated that fact. This is an extension of the restaurant and the bar. So I think we have to take that into consideration. I understand I got many letters of support. These are people that don't live next door. And to me, the people who are living next door are the most impacted by what goes on at this restaurant. So I give them a lot of deference for for the neighbors who are impacted that live next door. Other folks who live there use the restaurant. They go back to their homes, and they're good for the night. So I think a lot more work has to be done between the neighbors, the direct neighbors. I think a little more work should be done if this is going to be able to succeed as an extension. And I know the neighbors feel like they're being the bad guys here, but they're entitled to peace and quiet. They know they live next door to a restaurant and a bar. They're willing to tolerate it, but this is really, in fact, an extension. And I think you need to work it out a little longer. I don't know that I'd be able to vote on this today. And I'm hopeful that that you can get together, John, with the neighbors and try to work things out a little more. That's my comment, speaking for myself.
Thank you.
I'd also like to mention, you know, I'd be in favor possibly extending this to the next agenda. I think that they do need to discuss this with the neighbors in terms of fencing and the odor and the dumpster pickup as well. So I would be in favor of this being extended.
Chief, do you have anything to add? Paul? Okay.
If I may, Madam Chair, just to be able to respond to the neighbors that appear today, you know, as the first, Ms. Boyd's comments, who's the adjacent property owner in the rear to this property that have a shared easement for access. You know, we didn't speak to her before the hearing because it came at 3 o'clock to us, you know, so we didn't have an opportunity to really sit down with her and talk. I did a little bit of research just to look at the easement itself. There's a plan on record, and I could certainly make a copy for the board as well, but I'm not sure it's necessary. But I think, you know, we will certainly speak with Ms. Boyd to see if we can come up with some resolution on exactly where it is along that easement that she would like some privacy fencing put up. You know, not saying it can be done. You know, it's an easement that's purely for access for both properties. That's why it exists today. It's obviously for access for John's dumpster. He's promised to and he's getting pricing now to put some fencing, you know, throughout around that dumpster area. That should provide a little bit of, it will look certainly better in that area, provide some comfort for adjacent property owners. So we'll work hard in the meantime to speak to Ms. Boyd and see if we can come to some resolution. Both properties have existed for some time now, you know, and coexisted, and all of a sudden, you know, these complaints, you know, we have to try to respond to after so many years. So it's difficult, you know. I could certainly speak to Attorney Kellum as well concerning the easement, so we could maybe try to draft or clean something up with respect to that. I know there is a plan on record with the land court that shows an easement of record between the two properties. But sometimes these things go really undefined as far as the specifics on who maintains and things of that nature. So that should certainly be cleaned up. But we'll work with Ms. Boyd to see if we can come to resolution on screening and things of that nature. With respect to the other property owner, I can't, you know, her concerns, you know, with the bar, it appears to me that, you know, she thinks it's going to be open extremely late, loud through all hours of the night. And again, as I conveyed to the board when I opened this evening, restaurant. The entire restaurant area kitchen, you know, closes down at 9 o'clock. So no more food can actually be ordered, drinks as well. And John is going to be moving everybody inside. So with respect to that particular patio area or the other side as well, everybody's moved inside shortly after 9 p.m. You know, so it's not going to be an environment that's going to be loud and obnoxious, you know, throughout the entire evening, each and every evening. Restaurant itself shuts down before 11 o'clock as well. You know, so I think John recognized that, you know, with the neighbors, because it is dense. You know, there are adjacent neighbors pretty close, and people are living there as well. I know he did actually get a letter of support from one of Margaret's tenants as well. so not a concern of his, but I certainly understand her concern. So I wanted an opportunity just to respond to those, you know, particular concerns by the immediate, you know, abutters to the property. And that Brooke and John have not ignored these things either. Do you want to say a couple words?
Yes, if you don't mind. Good evening. I didn't get a chance to thank you guys for, you know, having us up here again tonight. I know, you know, many people on the board have stopped down at Off the Hook to kind of look at what we're doing down there. You know, Off the Hook now, it'll be a year, August 1st. We are an extremely family-friendly restaurant. We gear all of our hours around that basis. We see a strength in what we're doing with a lack of restaurants in the area like that. You have the Manit and you have the Hofbrau and other places you can go drink at, and we'll let them be that. We want a place where people feel comfortable coming in and can enjoy that. We don't want to be dealing with late nights. We don't want our neighbors dealing with late night people leaving our restaurant. You know, we've definitely done our due diligence over the last year and prior to make sure as we were structuring this restaurant that we kept all of that in mind. You know, one being the fencing that we put up around the patio area. As some of you have seen, it's high. The fence is high. When we went to do that, I did speak with the Boyd residents about that fence. Their concern was privacy at that time as well, which would have been over a year ago. We talked about if I go high with the fence, will that help protect you guys? And also then my customers sitting on the patio. At that point, it seemed like we had a pretty good agreement on going with a higher fence to protect all of that around there. You know, I'm nervous, you know, about adding any other fence going down the driveway close to my building. It is a restaurant. There are customers in there. Emergency exits are all along that side. Something tight against that building, I think, would cause a greater hazard. If the Boyds want to ever think about doing something on their side, I would be more than helpful. You know, if there's an option out there to make it, you know, work for everybody, you know, as well as the other tenants. I know there's, you know, the patio is close to their property. It does, you know, about the property. The dumpster is located at the rear of our property. You know, that's something we went over again a year and a half ago when we came in front of the board to move it. I feel like no matter where the dumpster is located on our property, we're going to have a neighbor that is going to be upset by that location. So we do our best to make sure that we keep that dumpster clean. Marley stopped by and Mr. Duca stopped by today. I have the dumpster being replaced on the 28th. I can do it once a year. I figured after this heat wave we just had, it was a good time to have that dumpster replaced. But as Marley and Mr. Duca saw, and as Inspector DeCarli was down the other day saw, I have buckets of bleach and Fabuloso and all types of items around there to try to keep the odor down as best I can. It was dumped today when they showed up. There was an odor. I'll agree with that, but we definitely do our due diligence on trying to keep that clean. And as for rodents in the area, this is Howe's Neck. You know, I have a letter. I don't know if I sent it over when I sent over some of the other stuff, but I can, from your bugging pest solution about, you know, the, you know, exceptional cleanliness of the inside of the restaurant. And the very, very rare activity of any rodents outside due to our restaurant. I have offered to the Boyds that your bugging would, through my contract, would put more bait stations around if they feel like that is a concern as well. And when I talked to John from your bugging today, he said I could also offer that to Peggy as well on her property if their concerns are there. But as it states in his letter, the Norwegian water rats are a Howe's Neck issue. It's not an Off the Hook issue. You know, but I know these people are going to have concerns. I know I get a lot of support. I know I have people who have concerns. And I try to take all of that, you know, into factor with every step we take moving forward down there, whether it's live music, outdoor entertainment, family activities, you know, the Oktoberfest and things like that. You know, I definitely consider everyone down there as we move forward. And, you know, the problem is that I can't move forward with some of this stuff. I've made contact with certain neighbors. We can't work this out if they're not willing to talk to me. If I've reached out 4 to 5 times, I have record of that. If they don't return a call, what do I do at that point? I've done my due diligence over the last month to try to spearhead this, and I've gotten zero in return. So I think that also through the last month, the patio that is in question, it's not as utilized, I think, as some of these people make it seem to be.
and there's been zero complaints. There's families out there. There's people for date night out there and things like that. So, you know, if it gets continued, it's understandable. But it's just, you know, this is, again, the season that we have to make this patio work out there. I've had 3 to 4 families looking to do an anniversary party, anniversary event, a first birthday event, things like that, that I've all had to turn down now, which is, you know, just lost business for us, unfortunately. And I'm hoping to see maybe that we can get some usage out of this area by the end of the season, if it's possible. And I thank you guys for your time.
Thank you. Any other questions, concerns? I'd like to say something for the record. I would suggest that we move this to the next hearing, okay? Regarding the neighbor's concerns, and since Director Duker and Commissioner Cassley are not comfortable voting today, I do understand the neighbor's concerns, and I understand John's rights as a business owner. I suggest that we come up with some one-day license dates that we can maybe do some trial runs on this outside bar, and to work with your neighbors before the next hearing and come up with a solution on their concerns, and you can coexist. Because at the end of the day, John, I'm afraid that if we do this too fast, and I think I'm speaking for Director Duca too, there's going to be problems for you in the future, right out of the gate. So to try to bring it all full circle, work with the neighbors, get some one-day dates that the board can look at and approve, and we can move forward. You know, they can see what it's like. You can see what it's like. You don't know either, you know? And we can go forward from there on our next hearing date of 8/16, with maybe 5 trial dates up until then. Does that sound like it could work?
I just want to understand how that would work, as opposed to
just a suggestion. Hold
yeah,
on.
Yeah, as opposed to you know, granting him. Obviously, the correction of the square footage, I don't believe, is an issue with the board, because it already existed. But with respect
well,
to the bar...
Well, under a temporary extension of premise.
True. But the original plan showed the actual patio areas as well. It was an inadvertent mistake that it was listed at a different square footage than what it actually was.
And we said we would grant it under the extension of premise.
I understand. With respect to the bar, and I just want to understand that, you know, your suggestion, I was only thinking maybe suggesting, you know, allowing it, you know, and certainly if there are issues, the board has that recourse to bring him back in, you know. And during that time, and before he probably even opens the bar area, you know, as they always have, Brooke and John, they've always worked with the neighbors and any current concerns they may have. You know, and I think John did a great job expressing that to the board.
I think that,
you know,
he expressed that there are concerns,
and they
that they do need to be addressed.
Right, and they
so
will
therefore,
continue to work, you know.
I suggest we move it forward to the next hearing, and hopefully we can come full circle and maybe have some test dates for the bar area.
Okay, as opposed to allowing that to happen now.
As opposed to
during this time, well, between now
nothing's
and the next
been nothing's
date.
Been worked out
okay.
with the neighbors.
Okay,
and therefore, if something gets worked out with the neighbors, and there's a couple of dates that we could maybe try the outside bar and see how it works out before we go and make a decision.
That. Okay, we'll do the best we can. I just.
That's our hope.
I don't know what we're going to be able to work out with respect to both of the concerns, because one is just the way they express their concerns. You know, this is not a late night bar that's going to be open late into the evening. It's strictly, you know, a service area bar for the patrons in that particular seating area. Secondly, with respect to the screening and things and the easement, you know, certainly John's going to make an attempt talking to Ms. Boyd to see if something can be done, but it's going to be difficult.
We were here a year ago.
Only because
on the same issue.
It's going to restrict access, yeah. Okay. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Just quickly, Susan Boyd again. There was no language finalized on the last plot plan I looked at. It said proposed easement, just for the record. And the other thing is it possible to wait until September for the next hearing? Just because it's summertime, people, lawyer, I just need more time. I would like more time to get my lawyers in a row, my ducks in a row, and to look at this language. I know people want to rush it. They have a short window of opportunity. I'm frustrated that this wasn't handled in the fall, in the spring, or in the winter. But I would like to see it, the hearing held in September.
I also would like to comment. John did try to get a hold of me, but this was after the bar was built. Also, he wants to have functions there, so he wants to rent out that whole side. I don't know how I got 28 seats on my side of the property. There's 16 on the other side, and I don't know what the couches are, if that are all included also, the two couches. But, I mean, 28 seats is quite a bit. So that just 28, you know, people talking with the noise, you know, the four bar stools and the, you know, I mean, a football game's on, anything. You're going to have, they're going to be backed up, you know. So if he wanted to get in touch with me, he should have came and spoke to me. My uncle built the fireplace in there. I've always supported them. His dad, you know, the Boyds. This isn't how it should have went at all. Thank you.
Just in response, last month when we had a meeting, we waited a month for the neighbors that were complaining. And they had a whole month to get their lawyers and to be here today and to, you know, present their case. So to just try to, you know, delay this, and they really are hurting the applicant. All I'm thinking while I'm sitting over there is Cagney's, you know, I mean, This is sort of like the only thing that is similar to that. And, you know, Mr. Chenette, who was complaining about Cagney's, I don't think he owns the building anymore. So maybe the solution is, if the people in that neighborhood aren't happy with that restaurant, because it seems that everyone else who lives in House Neck is happy with that restaurant, maybe it's time to sell the investment property or to move out of the neighborhood. Thank you.
Look, I think that Mr. Duca spoke to his concerns, as did Mr. Castley, as did I. I think that it would be in the best interest, rather than to vote today, to come up with a solution. That being said, I'd like to move it without prejudice to the August 16th meeting. With a motion.
Make a motion to move it. Madam Chair, so the five dates will be decided upon between now and then.
Yes.
Would it make sense for them to just apply for TEP?
Yes.
For those particular dates?
Yes,
and then
it would.
We can look at those.
Yes. Thank you.
And then when we do get those, we'll make some kind of a, we'll have to figure out some way to measure what's going on there. We'll figure that out.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm.
I'd like to make a motion to continue the request of Off the Hook Bar and Grill, LLC, doing business as Off the Hook Bar and Grill, John Galligan, manager, for an alteration of the licensed premises at 1269 C Street to reflect outdoor dining and patio areas of 1,625 square feet, which includes the addition of a new walk-up bar with four seats. the outdoor area accommodate seating for 44. I'd like to move that, and with the recommendation that the applicant, I'd like to move that to August 16th, with the condition that the owner will apply for temporary extension of premise request on the online portal for dates that he can select up to five. And with further conditions, once those applications are in, we can discuss more about the conditions and how we measure the impacts to the neighbors on that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you. Moving to agenda item number four, hearing regarding the request of the Quincy Hotel Operating Company, LLC, doing business as Boston Marriott Quincy, 1000 Marriott Drive, for one, a transfer of the inholder's all alcohol beverage license presently held by CP Quincy LLC, two, the pledge of the license to SM Finance LLC, and three, a hotel management agreement with Crescent Hotel Management Services LLC, proposed manager Kimberly Green, alcohol service from 8 a.m. to 1 a.m., Sunday starting at 10 a.m., attorney Corey Wilk. Hi, how are you?
Hi, thank you. My name is Corey Wilk. I'm with Goulston & Storrs, 400 Atlantic Ave in Boston, and Kimberly Green is with me. She's the general manager now at the Boston Marriott Quincy. We're here for the agenda items that you just said, and happy to answer any questions that you guys might have.
Thank you. So this is just new ownership and new manager and?
Correct. So it's a new ownership group taking ownership. Crescent Hotels and Resorts would manage the property. Kimberly would be the general manager, so would be on the license both as the manager of record, also is the general manager of the hotel. She has extensive experience managing hotels, although this is her first time as a licensed named manager of record on a license in Massachusetts. We are also seeking, in addition, the change of hours just to from 11 a.m. to 9 a.m. as a starting time, which I think was included in the application, yeah. And then a pledge in favor of the lender.
Great, thank you. Anyone here have any questions, concerns with the request for Quincy Hotel Operating Company, LLC, doing business as Boston Marriott at 1000 Marina Drive? Seeing none, board members, any questions, concern?
Were you gonna change the alcohol service to, did you say 9 p.m.?
Sorry, the request right now is the license says 11 a.m. to 1 a.m.
Yeah.
And we wanted to update to the, I think, what are the town's hours?
8 a.m.
Which is, oh, is it 8 a.m.?
It's 8 a.m.
Okay. 8 a.m. to 1 a.m.
Right, yes.
10 on Sunday.
I think it's later on Sunday. Yeah,
yes.
10 a.m. on Sunday.
We're looking for a motion on the three.
I'd like to make a motion to grant the request of Quincy Hotel Operating Company, LLC, DBA, Boston Marriott, Quincy, 1000 Marriott Drive, for a transfer of the inholder all alcoholic beverages license presently held by CP Quincy LLC.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
I'd like to make a motion to grant the request of Quincy Hotel Operating Company, LLC, DBA, Boston Marriott, Quincy, 1000 Marriott Drive, for a pledge of the license to SM Finance, LLC.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
I'd like to make a motion to grant the request of Quincy Hotel Operating Company, LLC, DBA, Boston Marriott, Quincy, 1000 Marriott Drive, for a hotel management agreement with Crescent Hotel Management Services, LLC. Proposed manager is Kimberly Green, alcohol service from 9 a.m. to 1 a.m.
8 a.m.
8 a.m. to 1 a.m., Sunday starting at 10 a.m., represented by attorney Corey Wilk.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you very much.
You're all set.
Good luck.
Thank you. Agenda item number five, hearing regarding the request of Shabu Shabu One, Inc., doing business as Hot Pot One, for an all-alcohol beverage license for the premise located at 7 Billings Road, proposed manager Ming Jing, proposed premise is 4,000 square feet of restaurant space on two levels, proposed hours of operation are 8 a.m. to 1 a.m., Sunday, starting at 10 a.m., Attorney Ed Fleming. Hi, how are you today?
Good afternoon, Madam Chair and members of the board. For the record, my name is Edward Fleming from Fleming & Fleming in Quincy. I'm joined today by Ming Jian, who is the named manager, and Li Chen, who is also a principal of Shabu Shabu One, Inc. Shabu Shabu, for those who don't know, is a Japanese hot pot dish, hence the name of the proposed restaurant, which will be a hot pot restaurant. The property, as you indicated, Madam Chair, is at 17 and 15 Billings Road in North Quincy. Seven Billings is the location of the existing commercial building, and 15 Billings is directly across Holmes Street from the location that's actually the location of a 13-car parking lot located in North Quincy. The request that's before you today is for an all-alcohol restaurant license in order to operate a restaurant from this facility. Ming has a great deal of restaurant experience. In fact, Ming is presently the operator of two different restaurants in the Boston area, one in Boston on Boylston Street and another in Brighton. Those are Japanese-style restaurants, and they've been very successful, and Ming has quite a bit of experience in managing those facilities. Ming lived in Quincy for a number of years and saw the environment in Quincy and the welcomeness of new businesses in the area, and always wanted to open a restaurant in this location. So when there was an opportunity that presented itself in North Quincy and on Billings Road, he took that opportunity, and he's been able to negotiate a lease for the building and the property. The property at 7 Billings Road has a long history of actually being a restaurant. Before my time, I can't remember it that well, but I know that Walsh's Cafe operated from that facility for a number of years until it closed, I think, a number of years ago, back in early 2000s. It was a very active restaurant at that time. Since Walsh has closed, however, the building was then converted to different commercial uses, and it was most recently occupied by an architect firm. The property across the street has always been utilized for parking for the businesses at that location. The building at 7 Billings Road is about the lot is about a 5,000 square foot lot, and the building takes up the entire lot. So it's about a 4,000 square feet of usable space within the building. The proposal that's before this board tonight is to convert that back to a restaurant use. The majority of the restaurant will be located on the first floor, the entry level of the restaurant of the building, although there will be additional seating in the lower level as well. There'll be about 176 seats on the first floor level, with 60 additional seats on the lower level, for a total of 236 seats for the restaurant. The entry level, the first floor will include the kitchen, the prep area, the main dining area, a buffet, and a private room for private parties. And the lower level will include the dining area, a small prep room, walk-in cooler and freezer, where there'll be storage, and an office and a large unfinished storage area. The property across the street, which is about a 5,700 square foot parcel, the parking lot will be redesigned so that it will accommodate at least 13 parking spaces, including a handicap space for the handicapped guests. And the remaining parking will utilize the Vane Street public parking, as much of or all of North Quincy does today. I've dined in North Quincy a number of times myself. I've watched the use of that parking area, as many of you have. And oftentimes there's spaces available within that Vane Street parking area. My clients also advised me that they intend to hire employees from the local area with the purposes of not only providing employment opportunities for local people, but also to encourage people to walk to the facility, to get rides to the facility while they're employed there, to utilize public transportation, which is very close proximity to the site, certainly with the North Quincy train station, to utilize carpools as well. And then any party that does drive, or any employee that does drive to the facility, they'll advise that they park off-site or make arrangements to park off-site so that they don't utilize the same parking area that the guests would. We think this is a great new restaurant in the North Quincy area. They're very excited about it. The building as it sits today, as I indicated, is an office space, so it's being completely converted. So there's not a space that the board has an opportunity to review and see right now. I did include the floor plans, I think, with the application. And we included all the other information about Ming's background, I think, to the health department, as I did via email, to share all that information as well. I know Ming and Lee are very excited about the opportunity to have their business here in Quincy. This will be a hot pot style restaurant, similar to what they've operated in other locations. It will be a buffet style hot pot restaurant, which will allow them to actually price their product in a much more competitive way so that it will be available to a lot of folks in the community. And it will attract larger groups that want to dine together. I know that some of the tables will allow for 8 or so to dine together. So that will be hopefully encourage people to also visit the facility in maybe 1 or 2 cars when they come in a larger group, as opposed to all individually traveling to the restaurant. So that's our presentation today. Ming and Lee are here to answer any questions that you have about them personally, about the restaurant. Thank you.
Thank you. I will just say for the records that this Shabu Shabu was advertised and abutters were notified as required by the ABCC. Items also received zoning board approval, ZBA 2226. Board members have a copy of the ZBA decision in their packet of materials today.
That's right, and thank you for sharing that information. And in fact, when we met before the Zoning Board of Appeals, notice also went out to the abutters, as it typically does, to 3 folks within 300 feet, and no one appeared, and no one raised any objection. I did also reach out to Councilor Harris early on in this proposal, advised him of the proposed use, and he didn't express any opposition or concern. He advised me, obviously, to provide the appropriate notice, and no further communication was received from him.
Thank you. Any questions, concerns from anyone here at the hearing today? Seeing none. Board members, any questions, concerns? Commissioner Cassley.
No concerns or anything. Just, you know, make sure to check in with our office so we can do an inspection before opening.
Absolutely.
I am in favor, you know, of this. I do love hot pot, so.
Great.
I'm looking forward to it.
Great.
Any other questions, concerns? Seeing none, looking for a motion.
I'd like to make a motion to grant the request of Shabu Shabu One Inc. DBA Hot Pot One for an all-alcoholic beverages restaurant license for the premises located at 7 Billings Road. Proposed manager is Ming Zhang. The proposed premises is 4,000 square feet of restaurant space on 2 levels. Proposed hours of operation are 8 a.m. to 1 a.m. Sunday starting at 10 a.m., represented by attorney Ed Fleming.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Agenda item number 6, hearing regarding the request of S&G Restaurant Company, doing business as South Garden Seafood, for change in 1 corporate name from Honey Cafe Inc., 2 offices and directors, and 3 ownership interest for the premise located at 217B Quincy Ave. Proposed manager Yishong Rao?
Yishong Rao.
Can you say it again? Sorry.
Yishong Rao.
Yishong.
Right.
And you're going to speak for the attorney?
Yes.
Okay.
He broke his leg, so he's
okay.
Not going to be here today.
Okay, so why don't you tell us what you're proposing there at South Garden Seafood?
Like, the you know, the same ownership, but I mean, just new managers, yeah. I'm the new manager, so.
You're the new manager?
Yep.
And the corporate name from Honey Cafe Inc.?
Yep.
To S&G?
S&G Restaurant Company.
Okay.
Yep.
And the new offices and directors, am I correct?
Yep, yep.
Okay, thank you.
Yep.
Any questions, concerns from anyone here regarding S&G Restaurant Company doing business at South Garden Seafood? Seeing none. Board members, any questions, concerns? Looking for a motion.
I'd like to make a motion to grant the request of S&G Restaurant Company, DBA South Garden Seafood, for changes in corporate name from from Honey Cafe, Inc.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
I'd like to make a motion to grant the request of S&G Restaurant Company, DBA South Garden Seafood, for a change in officers and directors.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
I'd like to make a motion to grant the request of S&G Restaurant Company, DBA South Garden Seafood, for a change in ownership interest for the premises located at 217B Quincy Avenue. Proposed manager is Ye Sheng Ran, attorney represented by attorney Ga Sheng.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. You're all set.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Good luck.
Agenda item number 7, hearing regarding the request of the Quincy Lodge of Elks, 254 Quarry Street, for a change of manager from Patrick McGettrick to John P. Connor, and a change in officers and directors, Frank Bertoni and John P. Connor. Hi, how are you today?
Good, my name's John Connor.
I'm Frank Bertoni. I'm just here to answer questions on the permitting. All right, because I did the paperwork.
Okay.
All the time.
Okay, looks like everything is in order with the application, and so any questions, concerns from anyone here regarding the Quincy Lodge of Elks at 254 Quarry Street for a change in manager and change of officer and directors? Seeing none. Board members, any questions, concerns? Looking for a motion.
I'd like to make a motion to grant the request of the Quincy Lodge of Elks, 254 Quarry Street, for a change in manager from Patrick McGettrick to John B. Connor.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
I'd like to make a motion to grant the request of Quincy Lodge of Elks, 254 Quarry Street, for a change in officers and directors.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
You're all set.
Thank you.
Good luck.
I'll be at Quincy Lodge.
Other business, update on previously approved applicant for Ina's Bar and Lounge at 609 Washington Street. The roof deck in the original plan has been eliminated. Modifications is a result of a zoning board process, ZBA 22-27. Revised application was submitted to the ABCC. Board members have a copy of the decision in their packets for meeting materials. Also, looking for a motion to accept the minutes and the hearing from June 21st and waive the reading.
Motion made.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Our next hearing is August 16th, 2022. Looking for a motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
So ruled. So granted. So